Hey, Liliana here at EDX Fitness with your pro tip this week, baby steps. Now, most of you guys know that I am 6 weeks postpartum at this point, and so I thought it was appropriate to talk about taking baby steps in your workouts. We welcomed our baby girl into the family and we are all doing great. And I have been working back into exercise. And so a lot of what I'm currently doing in my workouts, I realized really applies to what all of you are doing in yours as well. So I wanted to talk about how to make continual progress in your workouts, right? So what it really comes down to is baby steps, meaning not skipping steps in your progress, right? A lot of us wanna get to do the cool stuff that makes us feel really good, and we wanna leave out the unsexy stuff, as Coach Angelo likes to say, which is all of the gritty, nitty-gritty grunt work that really builds your fitness the best, but it doesn't really look so cool to do when you're in the gym, right? So, no matter what fitness level you're at, if you are restarting a program like I am, if you're postpartum, coming back from an injury, or just having had a hiatus from working out, or you've been working out for a while and maybe you're intermediate or even advanced levels in your fitness, the same rule applies here. So, taking baby steps in my workouts, at least, what it looks like is taking one step at a time. So if I'm doing a strength movement, I'm going to squeeze out that one more rep each week. So if my coach, for example, actually today, I have a coach, you guys. I don't write my own workouts. Every coach needs a coach, right? So my coach has told me to do 6 to 8 reps of an overhead press. And last week, I know I did 7 reps. And so this week, it took all of my might to squeeze out that 8th rep, just that one more rep in that set. And now I feel really good that I've actually accomplished progressing myself in that movement, right? So squeezing out one more rep if you can, getting to that top level of that rep range, would be taking a baby step. Or it could look like changing your weight up, right? Maybe you're gonna add a little bit extra weight this week than what you did in a strength movement last week. Now, if we're talking about body weight movements, pull-ups, push-ups, core work, now we're talking about increasing your body tension. So holding on as tight as you can. And sometimes it almost feels like I can't breathe. I'm holding so tight, right? You guys know what I'm talking about? So it's giving my full attention to that tension that I'm creating and doing that for every second that I'm holding that movement, right? And a note on that is if I'm doing it right, my body will actually feel really heavy afterwards, and that way I know that I've taxed my body appropriately in that movement. Another way to take a baby step in your workout would be to hold on, to fine-tune your form, right? So a lot of the time it's about quality over quantity. So it might be just paying attention. Are you pulling your abs in? Are you creating tension in your core? Are your shoulders pulling down? Are you pushing your knees out when you're squatting, right? Like all those little itty-bitty things that you, when you start to pay attention to, you might not know exactly what form is perfect right now for every movement, but the more you pay attention to it, the easier it's going to become to self-correct yourself in that movement. And of course, if you have any questions on that, just send us a message, you guys, in your True Coach app, and we can absolutely help you with your form, right? Even uploading a video there is great. And then in your conditioning, it means going maybe a little bit faster, right? If you're going to push that pace a little bit in your conditioning, that could be one way where you can push yourself outside your comfort zone just that little bit to help take that baby step, right? It's all about pushing ourselves just outside of our comfort zone, just one step beyond. And if you keep taking one step every workout, a year from now, you're gonna look back and see how far you came, right? So keep focusing on those baby steps, and I will see you next week. As always, if you have any questions, comments, I'd love to hear from you. Add them below, send them to me. I'll see you next week.